Is what we do on One Way Gospel.
What's up, what's up, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, Bit Ben, and you're tuning into another wonderful episode of Let's Go to Church. I'm sorry, guys. This is not Let's Go to Church. But this is Bringing Back the Choir's TV show with Bit Ben. I'm so used to doing Let's Go to Church, guys. Y'all bear with me. We're on our third episode of Bringing Back the Choir's TV show with Bit Ben. And today we have a special guest for y'all. I'm going to need everybody to share. Share, like, share to your friends, your family. I need everybody to send to inboxes. We got a special guest for y'all tonight. While y'all doing that, I'm going to see some of the comments. So, our special guest for tonight is Terrence Gamble in the Living Testimony Community Singers. And his manager as well, Mr. Sydney.
Hey, how you doing, Ben?
How you doing?
Man, what's up?
I'm doing great. Let me turn my volume up because I can't hear. It's on my end. How you doing?
Doing great.
Doing good.
Okay, so I guess we're going to start with the manager. I'll let you introduce yourself. And then Mr. Terrence, and I'm going to let you do a brief bio about yourself as next. So, Mr. Sydney.
Okay. All right. Yes, I'm Sydney Lassiter III. I'm the manager for Living Testimony Community Singers. I have been managing the group now, what is going on, 5 years now. Yeah. But it has definitely been a incline. You know, since we have been starting with the ministry has been around for 15 years. I've been associated with the ministry longer than that, you know, but as far as it, I've been helping with the marketing and everything from the very start of the group. But yes, yes, it's a pleasure being a part of the Living Testimony Community Singers.
Yes, sir. Mr. Terrace.
Hey, everybody. I'm Terrace Gamble. Just a little country. I'll say I'm not the country boy anymore, but the country man from Salter, South Carolina. And what brought me up here was the military, and I started the Living Testimony Community Singers up here about 15 years ago. I've been doing music since I was, directing choirs since I was 12 years old. So it's about 40 years now of me just doing music with choirs.
Yes, sir. So you were saying that you grew up directing and stuff, and you grew up around music. So please tell us more about that.
Growing up, I started directing when I was 12. I developed my ear singing with my father. He had a quartet group called the Mighty Jubilees, and I was singing in his group when I was young, and that's how I developed my ear. And then he gave me the blessing to start doing choirs, because I just picked up choirs because, I picked it up, looking after Ricky Dillard when he was coming on the scene. So when I started kind of picking it up and everything. So, yeah.
Yes, sir. So did you ever think that you was going to ever own your own choir, or is this what you wanted a long time ago? Or
Like I said, I've been doing choirs. I have another established choir in South Carolina called the New Inspirational Mass Choir. But since, the military brought me up to Virginia, that's why I kind of grew roots and I started the ministry here, because I really didn't want to start a ministry up here. But, God came to me and he said, you need to do something here. So he helped me along the way to get it off the ground.
Yes, sir. So please tell us about the military. How was it? How did you balance the military and directing choirs and living everyday life?
Well, just living everyday life, I managed to do rehearsals, set up rehearsals while I'm away. And when I got back, we just went back into the fold. You had internet, so we could send the song list and everything so people can practice. Right. And get things done. And I am definitely blessed to have Sidney Laster in my corner now, because he handles a lot of the business side for me, and I'm greatly appreciated of him.
And right now we're sharing this post all over the place.
Yes, sir. So the Living Testimony Community Singers, where did that name come from? Did God give you that name? Where did it come from?
Yes, God gave me that name because God came to me in a dream, and he told me I should start a ministry. And I told him, I said, God, I don't want to do no more choirs. I say, there's a choir in South Carolina. I try to get down there some to them, but I was like, I didn't really want to do it. And so God, told me, he said, nah, if you get off the ground, I'm going to help you. So I told him, I said, well, God, if you gonna want me to do this, you got to send the people. Right. And, and then give me the name. So he gave me the name Living Testimony in the Dream. So I added the community singers at the end of it.
I'm just be honest with you. That is a long name, but I like it. It's a long name. It's a tongue twister. I'm be honest. It's a tongue twister for me. So
yeah, but I'm coming back from the old styles of the Thompson Community Singers and stuff. So I'm adding that little part of it from that era. Right.
Yes, sir. So the new, I think it's a single. No, it's not. It's a single, right? Amazing. Yes. Please tell me more about that. The writing process of that, and what made you come out with that song?
Well, that's all Sidney doing there. He introduced the song to me. So Sidney can talk a little bit more about that.
I'm one of the writers of Amazing. Right now, the song has flourished, has actually reached the number 36 on the Billboard chart. So we were thankful for that. Hopefully it can climb up even more. But yes, Amazing actually came about from, me and my friend Larry Moore, he's also a songwriter on the song, but we were teaching someone how to sing. They was actually having a problem as far as being tone deaf. And by the time we got them on the right note, we said, God is amazing. And so really, from that, the lyrics started to begin. And God did. He started giving us the lyrics, and then next thing we know, years later, the pandemic hits, you know?
Right.
I said, God, I said, Lord, we need a song to speak to people. We need a song to, you know, speak to them where they are. So, Amazing came about. And I was like, yes, let's visit this. Let's revisit it. And I introduced it to TJ. And yes, we wanted to tell people that God is still amazing, no matter what situations you're going through. Yes, people are passing away left and right, falling ill. But we want you to know that God is still on the throne. He can still do marvelous and wonderful things in your life. Like me, through 2020, I didn't have a bad year. You know, a lot of people were saying, yeah, I'm having the worst year, but I didn't, me personally. The house I'm in right now, I moved in 2020. So, you know, God has done amazing things in my life. New car, the same exact year, too. So, you know, you can't give up on God. You know, no matter what the situation is, no matter what your problem is, you have to stay focused on that prize that he has for you and only for you.
Right.
Yes. Man, I went in. Since we already talking about God right now, I'm going to get both of y'all to say two favorite Bible scriptures. So I'm going to start with Mr. Terrence.
Well, I don't have two. I only got one. And that's Romans. That's Romans 3:5-6. You know, trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. That is my favorite scripture.
And
for me, you know, I always go back to John 3:3. I always want to be reminded of how you get to God. And that's it's verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, that he shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. And, you know, we have to be reminded always of his mission, always of his plan, you know, to get people saved and also get his music out and proclaim his gospel all throughout the world.
Yes, sir. So, you know, this is a question normal question that nobody really do ask in their interview, but what's our favorite color? Because everybody has their own favorite color. Red.
Nah, my favorite color is blue.
Okay. Favorite color is blue. So now we're gonna go to a short break. We're gonna do a video for y'all. I got one of y'all videos that will be playing live tonight. And then after we're gonna come back, we got commercial break, and then we're gonna come back. We got a few more questions, and then we're gonna ask y'all to tell where to find y'all at and to get the music and the book and stuff and all that, and then we're completely done after that. But yeah, I'm just waiting for my producer to go ahead and just play the video.
If you really love Jesus, you want to clap right here. Come on, clap your hands right here.
Oh, she cut it off. Okay, well. She said, okay, that's enough. Then you go ahead and buy it. Go ahead and buy it. So, I guess, oh, Lord, she just threw me off and everything.
All right.
I want to give a shout out to Ricky Nadine. She, Nene, she actually interviewed us before for the Praise Factor Awards. So I just wanted to tell her, hey, how you doing?
Yes. She's in the back studio. So, I already asked that question. Oh, yeah. So, what was your come to Jesus moment when you first accepted Lord, accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Oh, that been many, many years ago. I was very young, you know.
Right.
But I could remember what church it was. It was at my home church, St. Mary Amy Church in Salter, South Carolina. And we had a revival, and I can remember the pastor that spoke, and he's Bishop Floyd Nolan now of the Lighthouse in Georgetown, South Carolina now.
Mr. Sidney.
Well, me, my come to Jesus moment, I was young, I was 10, you know, and God came into my life. I went right. At the time I was going to St. John's Church of God in Christ under Bishop Green in Newport News, Virginia. But yes, I did. I had my come to Jesus moment right then at a young age. And he came into my life, and I'll never forget some of the guys y'all may know now, like Nathaniel Green and Pastor Nathaniel Green and John Moore out of Houston, Texas, you know, as well. And I remember they came up to me and was like, how does it feel? They never experienced it, but I tell you, God has been in my life. He infiltrated my life, and I love him for it. You know, I have never changed. I always stay focused on him, and you know, I'm just thankful for the things that we're doing even now, because he has showed up and he has showed out in ways that we can't even think or even imagine.
Right.
Yes. So, yeah. I'm sorry.
I see you got some questions in the comments down there.
Yeah, so I was about to ask you questions. Any upcoming ministry dates? That was one of the questions.
Yes. Right now we are looking forward towards our album release. Our album release is going to be June 25th. So we have a lot of people that are on our project. So please be on the lookout. You can check out our website at singlccs.com for those updates. But yes, even our boy Trayvon Perry, he is on our new single that is coming up, which is entitled Last to Be Alive. And it does feature Trayvon Perry and also his wife, and even our boy T.D. Sean. He is on it as well. So, yes, please take a look out and check it out when it does hit. It will be coming out in the next couple months.
Awesome. So one of the questions I've seen, what do you see? Okay, producer, put this question when it says, what do you see choir 5 years from now? What do you see choir 5 years from now?
I see choirs 5 years from now still surviving and still bringing great music. We're not going to die out. You know, I know as I be looking around, I say, so only a few of us still left, but, you know, we still got to pour into the young people to let them grab that mantle and push them, because, you know, I have a young guy in my choir that I made it the assistant choir director, Vashawn Spicer, and, you know, I'm training him. And I also have a young lady, Shavante Stokes. She's also the female, you know, directress in my ministry. So I'm training them. So, you know, because when I'm ready to sit down, they can pick it up and carry it on. So we have to just pour into the young people and get them interested into the choir music and stepping up, not just singing in the background, but also standing in front of that choir and know how to move that choir forward.
Yes. Now we're about to talk about your nominations for your awards. The Voices of Gospel, the Rhythm of Gospel. I'm going to have the producer go ahead and put the flyer up.
Okay.
Okay. Congratulations. Yes. Testament Community Singers. And I cannot see the name, the categories. Ooh, Lord Jesus. That's a lot. Okay. Traditional Single of the Year. Yes. Praise and Worship Leader of the Year. Group of the Year, Gospel Video of the Year, and Choir Director of the Year. So y'all need to go out and vote for them. Voting star. Yeah,
please go out and vote for us. Yes.
And that was two different award shows. That was the Rhythm of Gospel Music Awards. Put the Rhythm of Gospel Music Awards. And, right. And then that category was Community Choir of the Year and Contemporary Choir of the Year also.
Man, that's a lot of categories. Y'all, make sure you go out and vote for them. Vote for them every category. I need y'all to, I need everybody to vote for them every category.
Please, please.
So, this is all I have for y'all tonight. Is there anything else y'all want to say?
No, we just want to thank you for the opportunity.
Yes,
you know,
sir.
Because you took the time to, you know, reach out, and we thank you. Thank you for your support and keep playing great music and keep pushing these independent artists and national artists.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And I love what you're doing, especially with the bringing back choirs live, you know, event that you're doing. I mean, you know, people think choirs have gone away. No, that is not true.
Right.
You know, we're a testament of it. We've been singing for over 15 years. And you know, choirs have not gone away. Yes, they've been doing the praise and worship and, you know, having the praise and worship teams up and everything. But no, the choir has not gone away. You know, we are still here. We are never going away. You know, we have a voice and we have songs to sing. And there's some songs that I'm sorry, praise and worship team cannot sing. We need some more voices than just four or five people up there.
Correct.
So, you know, it's just a sound that we have. You know, yes, there's a Kevin Lemons out there. There's Patrick Riddick. Patrick Riddick even collaborated with us on our album.
Oh,
awesome, yes.
So, you know, we got people who are influences to us, but also friends, choir friends that help us as well, you know, and support our ministry. So, again, yes, go out there. You know, support the independent artists.
That's
where it has been lacking. You know, a lot of people look at the mainstream artists, but no, support your independent artists. You know, yes, we are the ones singing the mainstream people's song to keep their songs alive. So the thing is, you have to support us so we can get more music out there, so we can have more things. I mean, we got bills to pay too.
Yeah, we got a job too.
Right, to make sure we make music for you as well and support events. And so, because we're the ones mainly bringing in the major artists to our events.
Right.
So, you know, again, you have to support us. Play our music. Put it on repeat.
Yeah, Mr. Terrence, you already know your music's already on my station. On all three
thank
of my
you.
Stations. You already know that. So,
yes, thank you so much.
You're welcome. So I'm gonna tell y'all might not know. That's why I came. The reason why I came up with this show is because I was in the choir. I sung chorus in high school, classical chorus. So I came from singing. So I was like, you know what? They don't support choirs as much as they supposed to. So that's the reason why I came with this show. And then I was like, a year ago, I said, you know what? I'm gonna move it to TV. Have it TV, because originally it was just audio podcast. So it started out that I think my very first interview was Dexter Walker, was my very first interview.
Yeah.
That was last year, the year before that. But yeah, so tell us where we can book y'all, the website, everything.
Yes, you can go to singlccs.com and you can book us right there on our website. Also, you can check us out on Facebook. We're on Facebook Instagram, and also Twitter. All you have to do is do at SingLTCS. We try to make it very easy for you. And also, you can download our music on all digital media outlets. You can go to Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon Music. Alexa even knows our name. So please just ask her to play our music, and she will play it for you.
You will.
And make sure you go vote for them from the award shows.
Yes.
Make sure you go vote. And they're putting it in the comments. So you go back to the watch it. You can go ahead and see it in the click the link and make sure you vote. I think you can vote. How many times you can vote? Continuously.
Oh, multiple unlimited. Comments. Unlimited okay. daily.
Awesome. Yeah. So thank you so much for coming on.
Oh, we got merchandise. I'm sorry.
Oh. He said, oh, we got merchandise. I'm sorry. So go to the website and get you some merch.
Yes.
Yes. So I'm out of questions today. Y'all just answer all my questions. You answer all my questions. I had a whole list of questions. You answered all. I said, Lord, just answer all of them. So let me improvise. But yeah, we are done for today. I'm gonna have her put the outro video, and then we done. So peace, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ben.
You're welcome.